wish I got you. I couldn't ask for anything better. When will I get it? Hi, everybody. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today is Sunday, August 6th, and as you can see from the title of the video, this is going to be a day in the life. At least I believe that's going to be the title. I'll see how the day ends, but I didn't plan to do a video, but I thought, let me do a video of me doing some grocery shopping, of just doing my daily routine, or not my morning routine, but my daily, like in the day towards the evening routine. So it's not a getting up routine and it's not a going to bed routine, that type of thing. It's like just a day in the life. I guess that's the best way to put it. But yeah, so I just came and I was just thinking about something because I had a hard time finding parking. I'm going to Food Max first and then I think I'm going to go to Walmart. But I was thinking, God, I was having a hard time finding parking. And all of a sudden, those safety tips came to mind, you know, with human trafficking and sex trafficking and abduction and stuff. We are on high alert to just be as safe as we can be and just be ready. You know, we don't want to, you know, be stressed out and full of anxiety thinking about it at every moment. But we do need to have it in the forefront and the back of our mind at all times because it's really real. And this has nothing to do with the movie Sounds of Freedom. I have not even watched the movie. My daughter did. I saw a lot of reviews on it. I have pros and cons about it. But I feel like if the movie was made in any way to inform us, even though we all know that human trafficking, sex trafficking, and abduction, all of that is happening more than ever. It is extremely dangerous and happening all over the world and at a higher rate. So if that movie was made to inform us, great. Because some people just don't want to think about it or don't think about it or don't want to know about it or feel like it'll never happen to them. So I think if that was the purpose of the movie, I think it's great. And if it was in any way to help us have a heart, a conscience, or any way to be, you know, to do our research, to inform ourselves, to be ready, to be as safe as possibly, and to be ready at all times and to not be distracted, you know, and just, you know, go with your life with happiness and peace and put yourself and your family in God's hands. But at the same time, this is the world we live in. And unfortunately, we have to prepare. And like I said, go above and beyond to be safe and to be ready. So I was thinking about that as I was finding the parking lot. And like I said, I have pros and cons about the movie. I'll probably do a video at some point about it. And maybe I'll watch it. I'm not thinking of watching it because of the pros and cons. But if I want to do any type of review, I think that the best thing is to watch it so I can know for myself. My daughter, she's so good at explaining the entire video. But to see it for yourself, hear it for yourself, you have 100% better idea of what happened and what it's all about so you could give the best review possible. And I think it's just fair. So at some point, maybe when it comes out on DVD, I'll do that. It's getting hot in this car. I was trying to do it. Oh, shoot. I was trying to do it without the air because it's harder to hear, but it's getting too hot. It's in the 90s today. I don't know exactly what, but it is in the 90s. We are in the middle of summer, and here in our town, our seasons are very true, very extreme. So, yeah. So anyway, I was thinking about that. I said, okay. And I have been watching this girl. I'll put her picture and her name here. I see her on Instagram Reels. I have TikTok, but I never go on TikTok. I never use it. My husband sends me videos. He's into TikTok. But he's very responsible with it. He doesn't do videos, but he watches videos. And so he does more TikTok. I'm on Instagram Reels. And so, what was I going to say? So she's on Instagram Reels. I don't know if she does TikTok as well, but that's where I see her. And every time she comes up, I started following her, and she has a degree in criminology and psychology, so she's educated in it and she's well versed and experienced in it. So yeah, so if I haven't already, I'll put her picture of what her profile looks like So you can check her out and do follow her. Like I said, she has a degree in criminology and psychology. And she gives the best tips ever. There's a couple of others that I see. But anytime she comes across, I share with my daughters and, you know, friends and stuff. Just to be aware, you know, I don't want to overwhelm people with this kind of stuff. But it's better to be safe than sorry and to say I shared it. Whether they want to hear it or not, I'm sure they'll let me know. Nobody has. Whether they do it or not, it's up to them. But I feel good that I shared it because I love them and I care. So looking in this parking lot, I was thinking, okay, it's daylight, but things happen in daylight. It's not just nighttime. So I thought, God, this parking lot is full, but I want a safe parking lot. And I don't know what made me think about that. I'm like, let me start now. I got a mace thing and I got, I got two things that I ordered last year for my daughters and myself. One is a taser and one is a pepper spray. And believe it or not, I don't carry either one. And I haven't used either one. They're still brand new. My daughters have totally used theirs. So I'm so happy. And I need to, you know, follow my own lead. And so, what was I going to say? I keep losing track. So, yeah. So I was thinking about them. Like, even if it's daylight, there's a lot of people. What are some of the things that I remember from the safety tips? And that's like, don't park in between two cars if you can at all possible, especially if they're trucks or vans. And then when you go to park, make sure that you look in those cars that are next to you, in front of you, back of you, what have you. See if someone's just sitting in the car. See if they look in any way suspicious. Know their description. If something was to happen and you were able to talk, then you can say the person looked like this or that. So I did that. So there was a couple of spaces that I could, and definitely don't park. A lot of people do this too, where they park way at the end because they want to use that time to exercise. By if they're parked further from the store, they can use that as exercise to walk to the store and not be so close. Please don't do that. I mean, walk at another place, another time. Don't do that. Don't park away from the store. You want to park close to the store, wherever you're going, as close as possible, where people are coming in and out, or you could yell and someone could hear you. And then another thing was, be careful who you park between, who's in front of you, sides of you, back of you. Is there people standing around? And women are just as much as criminals as men. So don't think because somebody is a woman or they have a child with them that they couldn't possibly do that. Yes, they can. And a lot of these things are happening with child being used as bait. So we can't trust anybody. So yeah. So just look at your surroundings. Who's in front, on the side, in the back of you? Is anyone standing there? Anybody sitting in their vehicles? Do they look suspicious? Stuff like that. And where you see more traffic, where more people are coming and going. Like right now, there's quite a few people that are putting groceries in their trunk, or getting out of their car to go grocery shopping. People are parking in and out. So far, the people in front of me and to the right have not moved. The car that was to the left to me was a regular car, like a SUV. Nobody was in the car, and I didn't even notice when they came. I saw them. Actually, I did. I saw them, like, right here in this mirror right here. I saw them come to their car, get in their trunk, put their groceries, but I didn't see exactly when they left. Now we have another car parking here. I don't know if you can see the car. The car right there is just parked. They parked backwards, which my daughter does that a lot to speed out fast if she has to. So it's a guy. He looks fine, but you just can never know. It looks like he's with his son. So just be alert, aware. Don't be distracted. Don't be texting on your phone. Don't be calling on your phone. Don't be distracted putting music or putting things away. Go where you're gonna go. As soon as you get in car, lock the door. That is the first difference. Look around your car. See, when you're coming in and out of your house or a place of business or stores, as you're walking out the store, have your cell phone ready to call 911 if you have to. If you have your taser, your mace, all of that, have it ready. One of the tips that she said, make sure you keep your dominant hand free, because if you have to fight or push or shove or grab anything, you're going to be more stronger with your dominant hand. So definitely leave that hand free. Put your purse, your backpack on this side, groceries, what have you. it's always good to better go with somebody than to be by yourself if you can at all possible. That was a really good tip. And then as you're walking out the store, look towards where your car is. Is there people coming in and out? So if you need help or need to scream, you can. Look and see if someone's standing around their car, your car, who doesn't have any groceries, not really doing anything, just standing there. Look at the vehicles that are now parked in your car. If you were safe when you walked in, like I feel now, but are those cars gone and other vans and trucks have parked there? Look at that. You can always have someone escort you from inside the store if you feel any way uncomfortable or something suspicious. Say, hey, can you help me to my car? You could tell them why, or you could just tell them, you know, I'm not feeling good today. My back is hurting, which my back is really hurting today. I just don't have the strength to carry these groceries or go to my car. Can you please escort me? Please do it. Please, please do it. So I don't want to take up too much time of this video of all the safety tips and the danger. I'm going to do a whole separate video on that. I'm just putting it all together, what I'm learning, what I'm researching, all that stuff. And but I just wanted to say that because it just came to my mind, and maybe for a reason. So far so good. So I'm going to go ahead, get out of my car. I'm going to go into Food Max, do some grocery shopping there, and then I think I'm going to head over to Walmart, and I'll take you, I'll record as much as I can, and then take you on my day in my life. So stay tuned. I forgot my mask. Oh my God. I have done that only, I think, once or twice before, and it was a long time ago. I hate that. I have it right here. See, and I shouldn't even be recording here because somebody could come from the back and do something. But I looked at my surroundings before I went to the car, and I'm still kind of peeking. But I definitely want to have my mask. We have not stopped wearing a mask, and we will not. So normally I don't even talk on my phone, and I'm gonna go ahead and do it just to show you guys. I'm walking. That's kind of the view behind me. So here we go. Here's the cart. See how those men are standing there? That is weird. But they could just be waiting for their family members. So we'll see. So I start this way. I actually came in the exit by accident. Look at those conchas. I don't like them already packaged like that. They're not fresh and soft. I like them freshly made. So I'm going to get some stuff because my husband is sick. I'm going to get so here are the vegetables, some peaches. I know he got some peaches from a friend and didn't really want, but I'll get a few of everything. So we'll see. I just got some of the fruit. I was going to get a pineapple because my husband does pineapple. But I'm not sure that they're good. I don't know how to check to see if they're good or not. There was another store that he liked it from. So we'll see how it goes. So this is the bread section. We used to get these that had like the double pack. But then I really like these, even if I could get two packs. So I think I'm going to get... Maybe this one. This is sweet French bread. I kind of want it sour though. So let's see. They're not really soft. They're not really soft. These are softer actually. This is sourdough. So I think I'll get, let's see. I'll get this one sourdough one, and I'll get, this is whole wheat. I think I'll get a regular fresh bread, but none of these are soft. They're like so old. Oh my God, that one's hard. I don't know whether I should get this. This is not good. Should I get this regular one? I don't know. I don't know what this one's garlic. I don't need garlic. I don't know. These are really hard. Oh my god. No, I can't even. I'm gonna skip on that one. There we go. Well, we got these kind too. Maybe I could get a few of these. I don't like to touch them. Everybody puts their hands on them. That's not good. Look, the case is not even closed. Somebody didn't even close the case. It's up here. Look at the case. That's not good. I think I'm gonna get my bread somewhere else. I don't really need meat because I have a package of chicken and another roll of hamburger meat. And I think my husband might have some other type of meat, so I don't really need meat. Well, I do need some cheese. I want some Mexican cheese and I want my dip that I like. Is it over here? Oh, it's right here. No, it's not. This one is not good. It's crab dip, but this is not the one I want. Oh, no, they don't have it. I like the Mexicali dip is good. So I'll get probably two of those. But I'm really looking for a crab dip that they always have here. They don't have it today. So I don't like the smoking one. I don't see it. It would be here if they had it, but they don't have it. It's all smoking crab dip, which I don't like. So we only have a Mexican dip. So, okay, creamy spinach. I don't know about that. So let's move on. Mexican cheese that I want. So I'm gonna get this one. Let's see. I'll get this one. One of these. It's queso cortija. It's dry cheese. Let's see. I do need butter. So how are you gonna get this imperial? It's margarine, actually. It's the cheapest. I don't know, maybe I'll get it at Walmart. Might be better. I think I have milk, I can't remember. I'll get that at Walmart too. I already got American cheese. Salt cheese, cheddar cheese mixed with Monterey Jack. I have Mike's black cherry. No, I'll just peanut butter and jelly that I haven't been needing lately. I actually have some at home, honey. Salad sauce. This is the cookie and chips aisle, which I do need a specific chips here. Oh no, I actually can get them at Walmart too. They do have the bags. If we were needing like these bags right here are the best. So if I like made my chili bowl, I would totally eat that. Someone just put that one there. So I don't know where the actual bag is. There's the rounds. I like the rounds. I always never get the one in the front, so I'm just gonna get one. They're all kind of like broken. I like these chips. Cookies, crackers. That's this aisle for you. Have your peas ready to go. So that's where my car is, the white one. So I'm looking at the surrounding areas. There's no one standing around. No, gracias.
little kid selling fruit. I think that's my house. Let me see. Do my alarm thing. Have your keys ready. Only doing it a little bit different. So my car is actually right there. No suspicious cars right here or in front on the side of me, so that's good. Somebody put a cart right in front of my car. Don't stop to look, just keep going. Got my keys in my hand, not in my dominant hand, which is not good because I'm recording. But I would do it a little bit different if I wasn't recording. There it is.
So I'm back in my car. You can see I'm still got my mask hanging from one side because I'm going to put it right back on. Walmart is a couple of stores over, so I'm going to put it right back on. So I just keep it on one ear. And I got my bags ready. I bring grocery bags whenever I can remember. So I just used a few for the Food Max. And I hurried up. I kept looking around my surroundings. I actually stopped recording so I could really pay attention. I was trying to show you guys the area my car was in, what my surrounding cars were, and me going to my car. But I thought, no, still don't do it just to record. I'm sure there's another way you could show them. You need to get your dominant hand ready. You need to focus. So I actually stopped recording. I put the groceries in the extra bags that I had here in the trunk because I didn't get any in Food Max. And then I put them in the truck, shut my trunk. Good thing is where you put the carts back at, it was right close to me, like one car over. There was actually a worker gathering carts, so that was reassuring. And then I just got in my car and immediately locked my door. That's what you got to do. Don't put your purse. Keep your purse. If it's wrapped around you, just keep it on you. The first thing you got to do is lock the door. So I did that, got my purse and stuff, and now I'm ready to go. So let's head on over to Walmart. So I'm trying to find parking space here. I like to go in the middle, which is closest to any store, the middle. It's usually where it's well lit up. Again, we're in the daytime. So I'm trying to get closer to Walmart right there. In the middle, there's a couple of people standing there, but it looks like they're selling, just like they were doing at Walmart, some stuffed animals and stuff. I'm gonna go towards the middle. Can't go this one right here where they are because that's contrary to the direction my car is going in. Let me let this lady by. He's like selling stuff right there. So sweet. They work so hard. So this is the next lane that I'm available to go in. There's a parking space right in the front. Perfect, perfect. There's a little cart there, which is kind of scary because somebody gets it, they're gonna hit my car. So I'm gonna park in here. Which is good. Make sure I don't hit this person. So my surroundings is this car, nobody's in it. Nobody's in that car in front of me or this car or that car. So I'm gonna show you the back of me. So there's nobody standing around. Cars are kind of spaced out. I don't know if you can see that way, but this is a good spot. I'm close as you can get to the front. I'm in the first space. I'm in the middle. It's daylight, but my surroundings look good. So let's go. So I'm in Walmart and I'm gonna head to, I think the mascara because I need some mascara. So let's go this way. So. Oh, we need Q-tips too. Oh, okay, let's see. So, mascara. Where is my mascara at? Oh, that's Milani. I need them. So I'm looking for my medicine, my roll-on medicine, which is here. I used to get Salon Pass, which is right here. And now I get the Aspirin cream. So I could do one in one. It's a roll-on, so you don't have to worry about having to wash your hands. So I'm gonna get the Salon Pass, one of that, and one of the, this one. So I'll see which one works better. They're both the same price. That one's $10.48. This one's $10.14. Well, the Salon Pass is a little different. But I haven't used Salon Pass in a while, so I'm gonna see which one works better. Then I got my husband some Halls because his throat
having some coughing, but his throat is bothering him. But he's diabetic, so I got the sugar-free. So hopefully that'll help him too. So both of me and my husband love this brand of cookies called Belvita Crunchy. I like the blueberry. They only had it in a smaller box. They had his favorite, which is cinnamon brown sugar, in the big box. It's expensive here. It's like $7.98, and in Big Lots it's $3.50. So got one of those. He likes these too, but he can't eat that much of it. So I got some. I got two things of canola oil, which we needed. Two things of my favorite cappuccino, whether it's hot or cold. It's the Cafe de Vida French Vanilla Cappuccino. Got two of those. Got some flour to coat my chicken. Got the Shake and Bake Original Chicken. Haven't tried that in a long time. And I got a package of spaghetti. So far. Oh, and I need my sugar. I think I may get two because I'm running out of sugar so fast. This is my favorite sugar. It's so healthy. This is what I use when I was on keto. I only need very little of this. So it's organic granulated sweetener stevia blend. So I'm gonna get two of those. It's pretty pricey, see? But it's so worth it. Get some this yellow cake mix because I want to make some banana bread. And it takes the super moist cake mix. I already have some of that at home. Like, they even have keto frosting. My God, when was it when I was on keto? So yeah. Okay, here's my favorite drink of all times. It's the black cherry cranberry juice. They only got two. Oh, there's one here and one here. So let me get the one from the back. I'm gonna get two of them for now. I probably should get three. Let me get three. So I got some ginger ale for my husband, a 4-pack of Coke for my son, the 3 black cherry cranberry juices, 2 packs of Ruffles of cheddar sour cream. I made some white rice yesterday, so the leftovers I'm gonna make with this orange chicken. So we'll see. So here's the frozen foods. I wanna get my son some pizza. Rising crust one? I can't remember. It's pepperoni. I forgot. I don't know why I forgot, but I forgot. So they don't have any coffee ice cream either, it looks like. I just want to see the back of the ingredients. Got the blue bonnet, butter, margarine, whatever it is. I love the blue bonnet. Then I got some Jell-O's sugar-free for my husband. He loves these Jell-O's and they're sugar-free, so it's good for his diabetes. And a lactate milk right there for me. So I just grabbed a bag of potatoes right there. And then I'm looking at the bread. This is bread normally that you have to put in the oven. And make yourself. So they have a twin baguette. Italian loaf. I don't know which one to get. maybe the handbag app or a French. Let's see that. What else do I need? I need some bell pepper to do my sofrito. So I'm going to grab a bag of these. I usually like to bring one, but people have to do. So it's a 3-pack like I use for the spaghetti. I don't see the cilantro. Cookies. I'm trying to see if they, by some reason, have a crab dip here. They don't. They don't carry it here. Select stores. So, lobster soup, broccoli soup.
Items. You only paid for, like he did to Vince, he only paid for eyeballs. Unless he had two transactions.
So I just got done shopping at Walmart. I'm done. I'm so ready to go home. It is completely and utterly hot. I can feel the 90s for sure. But I looked at my surroundings a few times, kept looking back and forth, behind me, forward, to both sides. Everything was clear. Nobody was standing around. There was good space around my car. Like I said, I'm in the first space here. So I'm gonna show you what my surroundings look like. So that's the car in front of me. We're both in the first spaces. No one's there. I saw these people get out. Their balloons kind of were going out, and they were trying to stop their balloons. You see the happy birthday balloons in there. There's a space right there. This person just drove up. They're still in the car. I'm not for sure. Nope, they got out. And it's pretty clear. So nobody was standing around. This is on the side. This is how I got out right there. You see the exit of Walmart. Let me show you the back. So this is my back, very spacey. You don't see anybody standing. Pretty clear back there. You can see the Walmart exit and stuff. So I felt pretty safe, but like the safety tip recommended, to keep your dominant hand free, which I did. I kept my keys in my dominant hand. I could write and do a lot of things with both hands. I'm ambidextrous, but I am more dominant my right. So I kept my keys in my right hand, free and available to push that panic button if I had to. It also opens and shuts my car as well. Then nobody was around, so I was able to put the car back as always. And I just got in my car and shut the door. First thing, I didn't even take my purse off my shoulder or anything, just locked in. Then I turned on the air conditioner and I started recording here. So do keep in mind all those safety tips. Like I said, if I haven't done so already, I'll put her and any other person that I watch for our safety tips. They really give good advice. They have the experience on certain situations. They know somebody who has gone through it. And like I said, my favorite one, she has a degree in criminology and psychology. She's blonde hair. You'll see her picture and her name and stuff here if I haven't done so already. And this is one thing you don't want to do, is stay in your car too long. You just want to turn on, lock the door. First thing you get in your car, don't take nothing off you. If you have to, throw your stuff in and then jump in and lock the door. And then just get out of there. Drive home. If anything's on your windshield, do not take it off. If you feel like you ran over something, don't take it off. That's been known for them to get you to think that you stepped on something, that you broke something, that you hit something, to get you to get out of your car. A lot of things that they'll put on your windshield wipers will have something to make you pass out or to get you to get out of your car so they can take you. So video is not meant to scare anybody, but it's needed. The conversation is needed. The advice is needed. So if I appreciate it, I definitely want to share it with all of you. So those are something, if you see anything on your windshield, you think you stepped or hit anything, you could look in your windows, real quick, your rearview mirror, whatever. but just drive off. Get to a safe spot, if anything. If you feel like someone's following you, don't go straight to your home, because that's how you they find out where you live. In that case, you go straight to the nearest police station. And you can call the police department. You don't really have to call 911. There's a police department number. You should have that in your contacts or somewhere on a label in your car where you can stick it and just dial that number, because 911 is truly for emergencies. But if you feel it's an emergency, do call 911. Let them know what's happening. You think you're being followed. You don't want to take them to your home, but you want to just be safe. And so you're driving to their police station. If no one's following you, then of course, go straight home. Sometimes people, even if the people are not following them, they will just go in circles a little bit and then go home. It's a shame that we have to live this way. It's a shame that we have to do this. It's so sad and so hurtful, but this is the reality of the world that we're living in. And you know, that's not the way you want to end your life. And that's certainly not the way you want to leave your family. We just have to stay safe as possible. Go above and beyond and go out our way to do it. So let me go ahead and go home. Some more cars are driving up. And I'm tired and I'm hot. And my husband's waiting for the pool steps. So I'll continue on later, I guess.